Hey, what's up everybody? My name is Trophynut and welcome back to our replay series of Bioshock 2, where we try to delve a bit deeper into this game's story and secrets. So we've been on all the rides in Ryan Amusements, and now we're pointed towards the Hall of the Future. We also have the gift shop still available to us, but we're first gonna go for Incinerate inside of the Hall of the Future. So let's take a look. There we go. Should be easy, right?
You broke it.
I think, if I'm not mistaken, there's a turret in the middle of this place.
Mean. Mean, Roger.
There we go.
It was probably your clumsy, fat hands.
And there we go. And now the turret will activate in the midst of the two splicers over there.
Stay away from things you
It's a grog of a lamb's feet.
There we go. Don't let them damage it too much. There we go, another turret for us. Okay, don't get stuck on the scenery there.
So, you would drain the people of their life's blood. Rapture is a body, Delta. I am the voice, and Big Sister is the hand. When Rapture speaks of you, it says only this. Sleep now. Your day is done.
So now Sophia Lamb confirms that Big Sister actually works for her, protecting the little sister that she created. And these little icons indicate plasmids and tonics that we found in the previous game. So we have Booze Hound, Machine Buster, Photographer's Eye, and Rage. Sonic Boom, we have never actually used that, but that's another one. Sports Boost, Electrobolt, and this one is dark over here. What's this one? Looks like another Booze Hound, yeah. Okay, so now we can go on. We can already hear the sound of a Gatherer's Garden over there. So that's probably where we need to go. Let's take a look around. Hello? Ooh, what's that? Hello, Big Sister. That was another really nice scene for Big Sister. Just antagonizing us a bit more. She is a lot stronger than normal Big Daddies as well, so I do want to take something back I said in the previous episode, by the way. Is that heavy rivets are not, there we go, heavy rivets against armor targets and tougher enemies. So not against, to use as anti-personnel rounds, the normal rivets should do just fine for that. What's this? In what country is there a place for people like me, Andrew Ryan? Yeah, well, I don't think there is a place for, what? The hell just happened there? I think that was my gun moving. Not, I'm kind of a bit twitchy with all the dolls here. Hello? Okay. So let's activate a father's love. Let's listen to that.
We lost another of the Alpha Series protectors today in testing. Somewhere outside the city limits, he simply vanished. For these men, Rapture has no walls. We must find a method of conditioning them against abandonment of the little sisters. Something physical, possibly even lethal. The lab aides are starting to call them Big Daddies. Perhaps there's some genius to that. Bonded pairs, connected by a love that kills.
So another confirmation of the genetic bond between Big Daddy and Little Sister in the early stages, forcing them to stay together. And if we don't, stay close to Eleanor in our case, then we just simply keel over and die. So what is this? Hello. Loving couple holding each other in a pool of oil. Okay. But it seems like the Gatherer's Garden is empty over there. But that's just, I think, the standard model for one you can actually interact with. There we go. So Incinerate, Health Upgrade, and Eve Link. Incinerate. Always, so set objects and creatures on fire ages 12 and up. Okay then, so apparently children from 12, with the age of 12 could use incinerate already, but there we go. Incineration, when it absolutely positively has to erupt in flames, don't wait, incinerate. There we go, and now we have 3 slots.
Light up enemies to 1000 degrees. Warning, fire spreads.
Warning, fire spreads, yes indeed. So we could upgrade our maximum health and buy the Eve Link as well. And I don't see why we shouldn't. We could save up, but both of them are really, really interesting. So let's take health upgrade and Evelink. Get more out of your first aid kits with Evelink. This revolutionary new gene tonic causes your body to produce Eve whenever you use first aid kits. So we have an extra slot. So let's put it in there.
On your recent purchase of the incinerate plasmid. Say, Tom here is having a romantic evening with a gal. What would impress her more than lighting the fireplace with a snap of your fingers?
So now the Hall of the Future announcer actually tells us what to do. We should light the fireplace. What could go wrong? Well, of course, the oil is going to spread and just murderize them. Well, they're dolls, but still murderize them, kinda. And then we have the next scene, but there is a splicer in between there. There we go. Let's take care of him. We spotted that one.
But this party just hit the skids. Carl needs a light for his cigar, and no one can help him.
Yeah, indeed, no one can help him. Why should I help him? Where's the guy with the cigar, by the way? Is this the guy with the cigar? Is this the guy with the cigar? Doesn't look like there's a guy with a cigar. Maybe this guy. Yep, yep. Might have been this guy. So let's turn back. I'm gonna use... Okay, that was not what I wanted to do. There we go. Got a bit of Eve out of that as well. And then we can melt this place. There we go. Access to another area. And of course, there's another gardener's garden. Does this actually show anything more? Yeah, it does, of course. Armored shell. Should have saved up for that first, but never mind. There we go. Heavy rivets, trap rivets, heavy rivets. Heavy rivets will come in handy, of course, because they're kind of teasing it already, but we're going to have to face off against Big Sister again. Really, really soon. So let's head back out because there's nothing more for us here. This looks dark. There we go. So let's equip the heavy rivets. And we have a turret over here. Is this thing active? Doesn't look like it's active for some reason. Let's go with Electrobolt for now, and let's see if we can't stock up on a few things before we head into a fight with that thing. Maybe an Eve Hypo or two. We have enough rivets for now. I'm gonna have to check out my other stuff. Gonna have to go with the normal stuff there. And yeah, we don't really have a lot of choices aside from that. And we're getting pulled toward the entrance. And she's standing in a pool of oil as well. Ow. Let's keep her shocked a bit. Okay. There we go, and chomp! Oh, I do want to keep my distance. Let's keep Electrobolt handy. Oh, and there go the rivets. Oh, and there we go. Took a lot of my supplies, but the heavy rivets did the job. Unbreakable.
Not even a big sister can keep you down. Well, come on back and melt the ice and we can say goodbye to this two-bit carny ride.
Yes, indeed, but we still have the gift shop we need to check out. So keeping her on the burning oil slick did a lot of damage. So let's see what she has. 40 atom, a first aid kit, and $55. Which is sad, because I think I'm just 5 atom shy of buying armored shell already. Which would give us a bit of a defense on the side. There we go. Gonna have to be careful though. And there we go. Just save up on a bit of supplies. No doggy in the window. Stop singing. I really don't want you to sing. Stop singing. Seems like it's always this song, though. Let's take a quick look around. So booze, yeah, we can actually drink booze. Give me that. And then a lot of money. What's this? There was something disappearing over there. Yeah, I'm drunk, but I don't care. So, ooh, another one of these guys. Fortune teller.
I don't think so.
Yeah, so always bullshit. We don't really care about that, now do we? So this is another kind of, well, the gift shop, of course. I'm gonna just take a quick look around. I think I'm gonna use the auto hack dart on this one. There we go. Let's check it out. Ooh, anti-personnel rounds. Did that someone just come in? Yeah, there's splicers over there. Nope. And then I think I saw another one. Where is he? There we go. Ooh, squishy noises. Squishy noises. Let's see. So we checked this out. Let's take these thingies and cutting corners.
Used to be there was no margin in running the gift shop. I couldn't hardly sell off this tourist crap for a penny more than the cost of manufacture. Then I met a straight shooter named Sinclair, and he laid a sweet deal on me. Says he's got some hard luck folks down at Popper's Drop can whip up this junk at half the cost I used to pay. Yeah, I had to pick a needle or two out of the shipments, but all in all, nobody's the wiser, and I'm all the richer.
So there we go, the Sinclair helped out the owner of the gift shop to make an extra buck on the side by making the souvenirs in this place cheaper to make by using poor people to make them. Let's check out the ladies' room first, and we have a shrine for Sophia Lamb, it seems. Anything else in this place? Anybody on the toilets here, the closed off shacks? Okay, doesn't seem like it. Fresh water, thank you. Dollars, and of course, another audio diary.
I know the surface, Eleanor. I spent half a lifetime there, in service of the common good. But then, I heard my own words twisted by fat old men squatting over the embers of Hiroshima. Were the modern world a patient in my care, I would diagnose it suicidal. On perhaps that point alone, Andrew Ryan is correct. Rapture is deliverance.
And I think we just heard someone else enter the gift shop, but let's check out the men's room. What the? Okay, Shadow, some more trap rivets. Ooh, we can't actually carry any more of those. Okay, someone's flushing. Somebody done shitting. Yeah, that one is open. That wasn't opened before. Hello? Okay. Yep. Nope. No, you don't. Oh, you bitch. You set me up big time. That was really nicely done. I kind of forgot about that one. Let's see. Is there any other things here? Any saves? No, doesn't seem like it. Okay, so I think that's it for Ryan's amusement. What the? Am I just bumping around? Yeah, probably hitting stuff. Let's just get out of here and get on with our ride. So out of Ryan's amusements and on to the next stop on the train station. There is one more spot we could melt. I think it's near the entrance. So let's go with... We never actually used this barrel. I wanted to keep it here to fight the big sister, but I actually never had to use that one. Sadly, kind of forgot about it in all the
Ryan
mess.
Saw the individual as a hero, a noble survivor, and Rapture was his paradise, a shrine to the supremacy of the self.
Must be something beyond, and the result.
What?
Your noble sire.
Genocide, chaos. Now that the tyrant is dead, we are a true collective, a single family.
Okay, Lamb, that was a very nice speech, but I don't think anybody was listening. Because there's no one here. And as I say that, probably somebody's going to jump out of the woodworks. Let's see, let's melt this lovely pile of ice. 50 caliber rounds. Yes, dollars disappeared. And let's listen to that.
He's gone.
James was the only man I ever loved. And now it's like he never even came to Rapture. He heard me sing at the limbo room, came up all bashful. He liked hearing songs about what it's really like to live in this town. I think he's been trying to organize folks against Ryan. And now he's gone. And I'm here, singing Rise, Rapture, Rise. Scared to death they're gonna come for me.
So there we go, another character introduced, Grace Holloway. Clearly a singer. She's talking about Rise, Rapture, Rise, so the anthem of Rapture itself. But, of course, we know that Mariska Lutz was the one that originally sung it. But later on, she was replaced by Grace Holloway. So Eleanor's progress. Kind of missed this one, apparently.
Eleanor is progressing brilliantly. My physical participation in her birth was minimized, of course. It is vital that I am unhindered by nature's crude bias. I will be, above all, her intellectual progenitor, loyal not to her, but to the people she will ultimately save. But I admit, it is with some measure of pride that I review her marks in standard intelligence tests. As an agent of our beliefs, she may surpass even me.
So there we go, Sophia revealing that Eleanor, well, the birth of Eleanor didn't actually involve her too much. It was largely handed off to someone else. She's still the biological mother, but with the gene therapy and all, it's implied that she barely had to do anything to give birth to Eleanor. Do I need these? No, can't carry any more of those. So let's just head back to the train. Melt the ice in our way and head out. So there we go, incinerate. I'm actually not really sure. Did we actually go through this door? Oh no, I know what this door is supposed to be.
Outstanding sport. You're proven to be quite a windfall. Now just open the train tunnel from the security booth there and I'll come out and jump on.
So there we go, that's why that door is there, so that Sinclair has a kind of an entry point. So let's unlock the door. There we go, and now we can't really get out until we see this. Hello, Sinclair. He's talking, but there we go.
I like to look a man in the eye when I give him my word. You and me, kid, we're going places.
Yeah, goodbye, Sinclair. Get on the train so we don't need to actually interact with you. There we go, Sinclair's solution.
I had brought you some golem of Sinclair's, brought here to hold Rapture's arms while he rifles through her pockets. But no, you are aware of your plight. Who, I wonder, would be so cruel to force a mirror on a man with no face?
To force a mirror on a man with no face.
Claire was waiting for us. Come out shooting and start the train.
Let's incinerate this fella. And then let's head out towards this woman. Okay. There we go. This one's dead as well. Oh, wait. There we go, and now they're burning alive while I'm hiding behind this pillar. Fuck you. Okay, so everybody's dead, I think. That was quite a bit of splicers. Didn't really expect there to be that many. Let's see, can I... There were a few burning alive around here, but maybe some of them jumped into the water. Apparently not. So let's gather what we can. Kind of got swarmed over there, so that's a real risk with the amount of splicers ramping up. But now we can actually enter the room that Sinclair was hiding in as well. And he left us a kind of a little surprise, so wooden nickels.
Andrew Ryan. He reckoned the free market was some kind of holy spirit gonna lead us all over the rainbow. And I reckon it's a big fat hooker too dim to spot a wooden nickel. So old Andy went and became his own ghost, and I whittled nickels till I made a mint.
There we go. Sinclair clearly frustrated with the way that Andrew Ryan handled everything, but now that Ryan is out of the way, his plan can come to fruition. Warning, you're about to leave this level. Make sure you've done everything you want here before proceeding past this point. So, in stark contrast to Bioshock 1, you can't actually return back to areas you've been to in Bioshock 2, because we're on a straight path from one area to the next with this train, and we can't use it to go back. So let's head back into the train and move to our next stop. Here we go. There we go. And there's a splicer getting rampaged by what seems to be the Hulk.
Attention. Subject Delta is now trapped in Pauper's Drop. All railcar travel is suspended until he is found.
Yeah.
Remember, the enemy is alone. We are the family.
So we saw something big on top of the train.
Lab's trying to box us in, kid. This is a goddamn city-wide lockdown. To keep the train moving, you need the security override key from the local governor, Grace Holloway. She kicked me out of my own hotel down here, the Sinclair Deluxe. Find her and get that key.
So there we go. We heard one of the audio diaries from Grace Holloway already, and we know that she's kind of a singer. So it's a bit strange that Lamb would make her the king, well, the queen of Pauper's Drop, the area where we are at now. So the name says it all. Pauper's Drop is where the poorest of the people in Rapture were living. So let's check out this dead splicer. What a lovely smile. Look at that. A smile only a mother would love. Let's see. So bulkhead control, we probably can't enter because... Oh, we can actually enter, but we can't really do anything here. Because we need the key. Let's check out the trash can. Nothing really interesting. Can we check the pneumo? Nothing in there. What's this? Please have Rapture ID cards ready. Yeah, we don't have that either, so... Not really handy over there, so let's hack this manually. There we go, and unlocked. Yeah, thank you game for telling me the door is now unlocked. And we have a dead big daddy. Not really a great sign to start with, but there we have it. So let's go with the anti-personnel rounds. Take a look outside the window, maybe. Nothing out there, so let's see here. The door looks, well, crappy to begin with. Then we have Eve hypos. Thank you. More rivets we can't carry. So let's see. Now we have a gene bank so we can swap out our tonics and our plasmids. Don't really need that. And there we have. We will be reborn. A few splices. Worshipping a little sister heading into the vent. So we need to be careful here. Because of course these guys are all hostile. And a bit weird. Really, really weird.
Somebody there?
Oh, that one is shooting. One is shooting. Nope. I shall drill you to death. So there was another corpse around here as well on the table. So they were worshipping a corpse and the little sister that of course drained the corpse from its Adam. And they kind of laid it out here for the little sister to collect, which is weird on its own. So what do you see ahead? Dr. Lamb can help you plan for the future. So again, we will be reborn. So they placed someone... So a dead person over here, and they sacrificed it to the little sisters. What is this? This guy seems to be dead. Someone around the corner, doesn't seem like it. Hello, sir. Briefcase. Bullets. Thank you very much. Maybe go back to the rivet gun for a bit. Because we have plenty of bullets for that. Let's take that. The dollars. And bandages. I could use that. There we go. Thank you very much.
Some great
Oh, shit. Hi. So the Hulk just made a pass again. Hello, sir. The fishbowl.
Monster. You stole Eleanor from me. Twisted that baby girl into a thing so sick it can't even die. And now you come swanning into my neighborhood looking for me. Wrong turn, Tin Daddy. When we hang you from a streetlight and you choking out your last, I want you to remember my face.
So there we go. Grace Holloway is clearly not pleased with us. She believes that we're responsible for Eleanor turning into a little sister, and as far as we know, we actually are. Because Lam wouldn't do that to her daughter, so we don't really know who is responsible for the whole ordeal. Can we search this guy? Yes, we can. Anything else? Doesn't seem like it. So, Pauper's Drop. The first area here is a large open area with a diner in the center, and there's something really interesting I want to get inside of the diner, but I don't think we can actually bust this open. No. We have a drill, but apparently the drill can't penetrate wooden beams. Sadly. Let's go with the remote hack dart and hack the camera. So let's hack the camera. There we go. Let's see. Let's go with the rivets and electro bolt. I think I'm gonna have the drones fix that, so the bolts are gonna finish that off for me. So let's check this thing out, just to see, so we have at least... That looked like I hit it in the red, but apparently the game didn't really care. So that actually gave us two items, because we hit two blue areas. Maybe quick look and get some Eve hypos, because we do have plenty of money. Already plenty of money. So there should be a dead guy over here, and there we have our first little sister of the area with a Rosie. So a big daddy that's able to shoot back, sadly enough. So let's not get in its way right now. I think there's a turret somewhere, because I hear it shooting at someone. Ooh, this is getting loud. Let's steal this guy's drone. There we go. A drone mine. Can it? There we go. In the face. So this drone is mine right now. No? Yeah, there it is. It is mine. Don't know why it didn't attack the splicers right beneath it. Maybe he didn't register. Let's see. So there's clearly something on the roof. I'm gonna try and ignore that for now. Let's search the fridge. More booze. And with booze hound, we can take it. Let's see. I think there's more here. Beer. Because that actually refills our Eve right now. We almost have an empty bar. So let's eat all that. And go further into the diner. Hopefully not too drunk anymore. Because we're gonna need a bit of... bit of aiming, because it's nicely lit up over there in the corner. Our next weapon, and it is a very nice double barrel shotgun. And of course now we're gonna get ambushed. Oh. Jesus Christ.
But we're not done yet.
Okay, why can't I zoom in with the shotgun? Jesus Christ. Where the hell is that coming from? Okay, was the big daddy shooting at me? Oh no, there she is. There she is. Okay. I'm gonna try and take cover, cause... That's really annoying. Maybe go with a rivet gun. There we go. Another one down. So that was quite a big ambush, but we did get the double barrel shotgun in return. I really like this. I like the shotgun a lot more than than in the previous game. Jesus Christ. This is loud. Is that my drone that just passed the camera over there? It's a fine gin. I don't think that would get us drunk immediately. This door is closed. And I don't think I kind of missed anything. Aside from a few corpses, probably. Because that was a lot of splicers. I'm not gonna lie, that was a lot of splicers again, and it's not gonna become easier anytime soon. So, oh! Trap spears? Where were trap spears? I didn't even see any of those. Kind of walked right into that one. Let's see. I could try and take care of the Big Daddy already. I have a nice hiding spot if I want to. So why not, eh? Let's go with the normal rounds, the heavy rivets, but I'm first gonna set a few traps. So this thing should stay over there. There we go. I'm gonna hide in this room. So he needs to come across this hallway, if I'm not mistaken. Over here, maybe one. And let's put every one of those over here. So just to make a giant wall of trap rivets ready to bust its ass when it comes through the door. Telekinesis. So she's talking about tucking her in. So I do want to have... Where's the gas canister? Never mind, I'm going to take that gas canister. I'm ready for dreams. No. There we go. Running away. And he triggered enemies as well, so... Just going to hide in here. Is there another gas canister in this room? Wait. She's crying. What the hell?
What? He's nicer than other daddy.
Yeah, you changed your mind really quickly. Where the hell is the Rosie? Adopt? Hello? Join my crusade? Where did the... Wait, where's the Big Daddy? The Big Daddy just disappeared. Did the drones just kill it outright? I don't see a corpse anywhere. Oh. Yeah, there's a turret up there. Okay, so it can slightly see me if it passes over. But where in the hell is the Big Daddy? Big Daddy's dropped nice loot as well, so do want to see a corpse somewhere. Okay then, so I'm gonna just collect all my trap rivets again. Set out all these traps for nothing. There we go. Jesus Christ, woman. Don't surprise me like that. Okay, so I don't have a drone following me around anymore. I do have, however, a little sister on my back, which is good. Which is really, really good. If I'm not mistaken, there's a corpse over there in the corner where we started. But I do want to take a look here before we go any further. I think there's a machine gun turret up here somewhere, but it might be around. Oh, yeah, it saw me. There it is. There we go. Clear as day, so that's now my turret. And I think there's more shotgun shells over there. I do have to take a look around here, because I think, yeah, over there. So that's bridge. Takes me to a little side area over here. No separate camera, but there is a tonic. There we go. That splash is gonna get annihilated. No. Don't take out my turret. Better times with Lamb.
My folks lived in the St. Louis Hooverville in 32, and the drop is worse by a mile. Nobody's supposed to live down here, city pissing on us. Never try. Ryan doesn't care, and Fontaine's a damn crook. But Dr. Lamb cares. still people to her. She's offering free mental counseling on Sundays. When I go, I get the feeling she's got a plan for Rapture. And for me.
So there we go, Grace Holloway starting to get into the clutches of Sophia Lam. And we have another tonic here, Hacker's Delight. We know that one, so we have run out of tonic slots. No biggie, because I don't think I'm going to use Hacker's Delight. So your body converts the altered current from a hack machine into a powerful healing agent. Hack and heal. I think I like everything else better. So sports boost, drill power, booze hound, and eveling. So let's keep it as it is for now. And I think that's everything around here. I'm going to, of course, take the trap rivets, the heavy rivets. And you know what? Maybe it's a good time to set up a few traps and... You know what? I'm going to do that in the next episode. So when we get back, I'm going to... Okay, so the camera clearly saw something. When we get back, we're going to gather Adam from this corpse. But right now, I'm going to take a little break. So thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel, because I really, really appreciate any support you guys can give me. So thanks again enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or series. Goodbye!